The Alto Feliciano Farm, a work in progress, transforming an ugly duckling to a beautiful swan, or perhaps we should say a beautiful nyandu. Just a while back we bought a junker farm called San Gabriel. It was a true mess. It had seen better days. It looked like a bomb had dropped, or the Air Force was using the farm for bombing practice. Everything was in a shambles, unmaintained, filthy, badly designed, or simply falling down. We are now in a transition from one era to another, from chemicals to organic. There is still another transition to be made, back to a new animal traction future, but that's a conversation for another day. For now, we had to get to rebuilding this falling down and decayed farm. The first order of business was to get the erosion under control. Getting a grip on some of these erosion gullies is a challenge. Erosion is destroying topsoils in Entre, Ríos province more than any other negative factor affecting farmland. Unchecked, owners of hilly land can kiss the value of their farm goodbye. Many hapless owners renting out their farms suffer unbelievable damage to their properties, several times greater than those farmers who work their own land. Careful restoration techniques can be used to stop erosion and to patch and prevent further damage. Small dams and gullies slows down water runoff and reduces its eroding force, then permitting patching that may take a couple of seasons to sew up like sutures to the skin. In time, it will knit back together when carefully tilled and planted out, and then look like this. The Alto Feliciano farm is split evenly between low wetlands, savannas, and arable land as you see here. All grazing had to be eliminated in the wetlands to give way to wildlife. After all, we humans cannot rob all the habitat of wildlife, as we consistently do. We must remember that as farmers and landowners, we are obliged both ethically and practically to conserve biodiversity and share the planet with other creatures. Infrastructure, as we have seen, was over the hill. Everything from corrals, fences, gates, sheds, housing, water tanks, and so on, all had to be rebuilt. So the building began. A marvelous bomb-proof corral replaced the old one. Practically all the farm is now with new fences. Houses were rebuilt and nicely painted with new dazzling colors to put forth a new face for the farm. Some houses were built from scratch, and our trusty contractor, the Ziegler Company, was brought in to do the work. Design and production supervision was done by Arquitectura de la Tierra, our experienced architects who we've worked with on many other projects for years. Now let's get out on the ground and see what we've been doing. The first order of business was to get our cattle, sheep, and horses down to an optimum stocking level for the carrying capacity of our savanna's natural grasses. With sheep and cattle and grazing rotations that utilize our grasses in a way that keeps the system healthy. Our steers are already looking good and getting fat on this good grazing regime. Horses as sleek as anyone could ask for. Now with new efficient corrals, we're not stirring up a lot of dust, chasing our cattle from corner to corner. Instead, quiet and calm steers walking gently into their baths or vaccinations. Getting our agricultural land in shape has required some rethinking from the conventional chemical farming being done by our predecessors. We certainly didn't want our farm to look like these ugly industrial monsters springing up all around us. Virtual horrors vested on the land. How vulgar it would be to just produce for money and not have beauty. Living and working in beautiful, alive, and vibrant landscapes is what gives purpose to our work and makes life worth living. So beauty and the importance of aesthetics are always present in every decision we make. From how our farm is designed, to how we plow and seed our fields, to how the roadsides are finished. or the wildflowers that give our farms pleasure for the eyes. Now our soil is looking like the rich and fertile earth that it should and must be, and finding a compatibility between conservation and production. Here, we are chopping our cover crops to incorporate in our soils, thus avoiding chemical fertilizers, or making some additional feed for our animals to avoid overgrazing in case of a harsh winter or drought. Interdispersed grains and grasses make for higher diversity, avoiding the need for chemical pest and weed controls. For these are the techniques that make a real organic farm work and brings meaning to our labors, and what makes biodiversity conservation a consequence of good production. So now we're ready to hang our new name and christen this renewed farm. We're almost there with a rebirth of San Gabriel to the newborn Alto Feliciano. New houses, new interiors, new machines, and new infrastructure. Alto Feliciano, born again. Without forgetting that the majority of the credit for the rebirth of Alto Feliciano goes to Ivan Pecossi, the general manager.